Hello viewers, today in the start of this session, we will start with the topic proteins. Proteins are the important biomolecules of the cells. They are the nitrogen containing compounds. The building block of the protein is amino acids and they play a dynamic role in the cells. We can define the protein as the polymers of amino acids produced by living cells in all form of life, whether the plant, whether the animals, whether the microbes. Proteins are made up of amino acids. There are 20 amino acids are commonly found in proteins. These 20 amino acids are linked together through peptide bonds forming peptides and proteins. These 20 amino acids take part in the synthesis of a variety of proteins. The chain containing less than 50 amino acids are called peptides, while those containing greater than 50 amino acids are called proteins. This is the difference between the peptides and proteins. A typical protein contains 200 to 300 amino acids, but some are much smaller and some are much larger. Proteins range in molecular weight from 6000 Dalton to millions of Dalton. The small molecular weight proteins are found in as the example of insulin, while the structural proteins are high in molecular weight. Peptide bond formation. How this peptide bond formed in the proteins? Peptide bond form by the alpha carboxylic group of one amino acids and the alpha amino group of another amino acids, and by this bond there is a removal of a molecule of water. When the two amino acids are joined, result is dipeptide. The two amino acids linked by one peptide bond is called the dipeptide. Similarly, in the same way, dipeptides can then form another peptide bond with a third amino acids and form a tripeptide. Polypeptides are the repetition of the amino acids and form a peptides or proteins. This diagram shows the peptide bond formation. Each polypeptide chain starts on the left side by free amino group. You can see in the diagram, free amino group of the first amino acids enter in the chain formation and it is termed as N-terminus. And each polypeptide chain end on the right side by free COH group on the last amino acid and termed as C-terminus. You can see this in the diagram. We can classify the proteins on the basis of function, chemical nature and solubility properties, and nutritional importance. Now, first we will classify the proteins on the basis of functions. The proteins have been classified into 9 groups on the basis of various functions they perform. The first is the structural proteins. The keratins of hair, nails, and collagen of bones comes in the structural proteins. Proteins are also function as the enzyme or catalyst. Enzymes, as you know, are the molecules which catalyze a biological reaction or speed up a reactions. The example of catalytic proteins are hexokinase and pepsins. And another class of the protein is the transport protein. The example of transport protein is hemoglobin and serum albumin. Hemoglobin is the pigment proteins involved in the transport of oxygen from one cell to the another cells. Protein also have the hormonal function. The example of hormonal protein is insulin and growth hormone. Contractile proteins. The example of contractile protein and actin and myosins. They are present in the muscle tissues and involved in the contractions of the muscles. The storage proteins are oval albumin and glutin. Genetic proteins are nucleoproteins and they are present in the nucleus and carry out the genetic information. Defense proteins are snake venom and immunoglobulins, and they provide the defense against the diseases for the cells. The example of receptor proteins are hormones and viruses. Proteins are also classified on the chemical nature and solubility, and this is a more comprehensive and popular classification of protein. It is based on the amino acid composition, structure, shape and solubility properties. On this basis, the proteins has been classified into three groups. Simple proteins. Simple proteins are composed of only amino acid residue. They are grouped into globular proteins and scleroproteins. Globular proteins. These proteins are spherical in shape, soluble in water and other solvent, and digestible. Following are the example of globular proteins. Number 1, albumin and globulins. Albumin and globulins are present in egg, milk and blood. They are proteins of high biological value and contain all essential amino acids that is required for the cells and easily digested. Second, prolamins. They are the storage proteins and they have been detected only in the plant sources. Example are zein from maize seeds and hordein from barley. Another is glutin. They are also the storage proteins. They are soluble in dilute solution of acids and bases. They are mainly found in seeds of dicotyledons plants. Protamines, simple and smallest and having the molecular weight about 5000 Dalton. They are soluble in water and ammonium hydroxide solution. They are abundantly present in fish and egg yolk. Next class of protein is histones. These proteins are rich in basic amino acid such as histidine. They are present in nucleus and combine with DNA and form the nucleoproteins and carry out the genetic information, or they can combine with the heme to form the hemoglobin of red blood corpuscles. The another class of the protein is scleroprotein. The scleroproteins, unlike the globular proteins, are fiber like in shape. They are insoluble in water and other common solvents. Their main function is architectural structure and localized in the connective tissue, bone, hair, skin, wool, silk, etc. The scleroproteins are of two types, keratins and collagens. Keratins are generally found in epidermal structure and contain variable amount of sulfur containing amino acids. The sulfur containing amino acids may be methionine, cysteine and cysteine. The collagen are characterized by high content of glycine, proline and hydroxyproline and lack in sulfur containing amino acids. Prolonged boiling convert collagen to soluble protein termed gelatin. This is the another class of the protein called the conjugated proteins. This protein, in addition to the amino acids, contain the prosthetic group such as nucleic acids, carbohydrate, lipid, metal, etc. The example of conjugate proteins are nucleoproteins. When the proteins are conjugates with nucleic acids, it may be DNA and RNA, and they are called the nucleoproteins. Example of nucleoprotein is histones, and they are present in the nucleus and play important role in the genetic information. Second class is lipoproteins, and these are the conjugates of lipid and proteins. The example of lipoprotein is blood serum. Phosphoproteins, when the proteins containing phosphoric acid as prosthetic group, the example of phosphoprotein is casein of milk and vitellin of egg yolk. When the carbohydrates are attached covalently to the protein part, then it forms the glycoprotein. The example of glycoprotein is fibrinogen, ribonuclease and pepsins. Chromoprotein, it is also called as the pigment protein, in which prosthetic group is attached to the protein part of the enzymes. The example of chromoprotein is hemoglobin, which is present in the RBC cells and carried out the oxygen from one cell to the another cell. Third group of the protein is derived proteins. These are the denatured or degraded product of simple and conjugated proteins. They are of two types, primarily derived proteins and secondary derived proteins. Primary derived proteins are produced by agent such as heat, acid and alkaline. Secondary derived proteins are the hydrolytic products of the simple and conjugated proteins. This is the classification of protein based on nutrition. The nutritive value of protein is determined by the composition of essential amino acids. From the nutritional point of view, proteins are classified into three categories: complete protein, partially incomplete protein, and incomplete protein. Complete proteins are, these proteins have all the 10 essential amino acids in required proportion by the human body to promote growth. Example of complete proteins are egg albumin, milk caseins, etc. These proteins are complete from the nutritional point of view because they have all the 10 essential amino acids in the protein. Partially incomplete proteins, these proteins are partially lacking one or more essential amino acids and hence can promote moderate growth. The example of partially incomplete protein is wheat and rice proteins. They are partially incomplete because they lacking one or more essential amino acids. Incomplete proteins, these protein completely lack one or more essential amino acids, hence they do not promote growth. The example of this protein is gelatin. So, incomplete proteins are nutritional point of view, they are not important. Now, the proteins are fourth structural level of organization: primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure and quaternary structure. Primary structure determine the linear sequence of amino acids forming the backbone of the proteins. Secondary structure determine the spatial arrangement of protein by twisting of the polypeptide chain. Tertiary structure is the three-dimensional structure of a functional protein, while the quaternary structure in which some of the protein are composed of two or more polypeptide chain known as subunits. The spatial arrangement of this subunit is known as quaternary structure. Now, we will start with the primary structure of the protein. Primary structure is the linear form of the polypeptide chain. This structure determines the number of amino acids, chemical nature of the amino acids, and the sequence of the amino acids in a polypeptide chain or the position of disulfide bond present in the polypeptide chain. These peptide bonds are responsible for the primary structure. The conformation of polypeptide chain by twisting or folding is referred to as secondary structure. In the secondary structure, polypeptide chains are close to each other in their sequence. Two types of secondary structure are found, that is alpha helix and beta sheet. In the next, we will see how the alpha helix is formed and how the beta sheet is formed. Alpha helix is a tightly packed amino acid chain which is extending outward from the central axis. The alpha helix is stabilized by extensive hydrogen bonding, and this hydrogen bonding is found between hydrogen atom attached to the peptide nitrogen and oxygen atom attached to the peptide carbon. The hydrogen bonds are individually weak, but collectively they are strong enough to stabilize the helix. All the peptide bonds except first and last in a polypeptide chain participate in hydrogen bonding. In the next slide, we can see how the alpha helix structure is formed. So, you can see in the diagram the alpha helix structure. The hydrogen bond it form between the hydrogen atom of the peptide nitrogen and oxygen atom of the carbon peptide carbon atom. You can see that each turn of the alpha helix contain about 3.6 amino acids and travel a distance of 0.54 nanometer. The spacing of each amino acid is 0.15 nanometer. The alpha helix is a stable conformation form spontaneously with the lowest energy. The another secondary structure level of protein is beta strand or beta sheet. Beta sheet are composed of two or more segments of fully extended peptide chain. In the beta sheet, the hydrogen bonds are formed between the neighboring segment of polypeptide chain. You can see that in the alpha helix structure, intra-chain hydrogen bonds are formed between the amino acids, while in the beta sheet, inter-chain hydrogen bonds are formed between the two polypeptide chain. The beta sheets make up the core of many protein. In the beta sheet, the polypeptide chain may be parallel or anti-parallel chain. In the parallel chain, two polypeptide chain running in the same direction held together by hydrogen bonds. While in the anti-parallel chain, two polypeptide chain running in the opposite direction held together by hydrogen bonds. In the next slides, we can show the structure of the beta sheet. This is the structure of the beta sheet in the parallel and anti-parallel direction. In the parallel direction, the two amino acids chain running in the same direction, while in the anti-parallel beta sheet, the two polypeptide chains running in the opposite direction. Now we come to the biological importance of proteins. Proteins play an important role in different way. Nutritional role. In the nutritional role, they provide the body with essential amino acids, nitrogen and sulfur to the body. Essential amino acids are those which cannot be synthesized by the human body and they are taken out from the outside. Second important role of protein is catalytic, and enzymes are proteinaceous in nature, and proteins play an important role in the enzyme or as a catalyst. They increase the rate of reaction without being disturbed the overall process of the reaction. They also have the hormonal role. Most of hormones and all receptors are protein in nature. The another important role of protein is in defense. The antibody immunoglobulins play an important role in the body's defensive mechanisms are protein in nature. The another important role of protein is stress mitigation. In plants, various types of proteins have been identified which play an important role in mitigating the effect of stress. For example, osmotins, dehydrins, LEA and heat shock proteins. Osmotins, dehydrins and LEA proteins play important role under drought conditions, while the heat shock proteins play an important role for stress mitigation under high temperature condition. Another important role of protein is transport, and proteins carry lipid in the blood forming lipoprotein complexes. Structural role. Proteins are the main structural component in bone, muscles and cell membrane in the form of keratins and collagen. Next important function of the protein is gene expression, and most factor required for DNA replication, transcription and messenger RNA translations are protein in nature. During DNA replication, multiple copy of the DNA are produced. Transcription, DNA is transcribed to synthesize mRNA, and in the process of translation, messenger RNA is synthesized a proteins, and in all this process, different proteins are required. Proteins are the important biomolecules of the cells. They are composed of the amino acids, and 20 amino acids by the peptide bond synthesize a variety of different proteins, and these proteins have structural and dynamic function in the cells. Proteins are made up of amino acids joined together by the polypeptide chain. Proteins are classified into three groups: simple proteins, conjugated proteins and derived proteins. There are four structural level of organization of proteins. In this session, we have studied the primary structure and secondary structure. In the primary structure, determine the amino acid sequence in a polypeptide chain, while the secondary structure determine the intra-chain hydrogen bonding between the polypeptide chain, which include the alpha helical structure and beta sheet. The proteins, in the last, proteins have the biological important functions in the cell, such as stress mitigation, defense proteins, hormonal proteins, catalytic role, etc. So, I hope you enjoy the session. Thank you.